Hi, it's Shanibek Yeskindir, Tech Lead at Systems Consult. Welcome to our channel Automation Portal, which will bring you to a world of industrial automation. Today we'll talk about level 2 of ICSS architecture, which is supervisory control level. The topic is big. In this video, we'll give high-level overview. However, we plan to deep dive into details in future videos. Therefore, please keep subscribed to our channel. Level 2 resides between level 1 and level 3 switches. At level 2, most important component is operator console for supervisory control. Everything here serves for this purpose. SCADA server collects data from PLCs and represents results on operator screen. Operator console gets HMI data, trends and alarms from the server. Today, with virtualization, most of level 2 systems runs on VMs deployed on ESXi hosts. SCADA servers and clients are not an exception. Therefore, today's operator console is a set of monitors, keyboards and mouse connected to the thin client. Thin client does not have much computational power and thus provides a remote desktop to a virtual machine with SCADA client application. Virtual machine with SCADA client application retrieves data from the virtual machine with SCADA server application. SCADA servers at level 2 are the central part from data flow point of view. Controllers and field devices from level 1 communicates to level 2 SCADA servers by Modbus or other protocols. SCADA server stores all configuration and real-time data. To authenticate and validate user access on the network and for centralization purposes, domain controllers are used. From best practice, each segment should have its own domain controller. Topics to dive in for level 2 are DCS, SCADA server, points, databases, all configs as addresses, scales, alarms, and so on. HMI, good practices, scripting, building of HMIs, history, trends, DSA, which stands for distributed server architecture, OPC, scripting, security. Networks, switching TCP/IP, VLANs, spanning tree protocol, switch site and host site network configurations, static routing and HSRP. PC hardware, servers, network attached storages, thin clients, KVMs, Windows, server administration, client administration, domain controllers and group policies. Virtualization, VMware products, vCenter, ESXi hosts and so on. Thank you